Cześć! In this video, I would like to tell you about the formal and informal language in Polish. My name is Monika, and in this channel, I teach Polish. If you would like to learn more the Polish language, you are welcome to visit my website, where you can find different video courses and other resources that will help you learn Polish. Now let's have a look at the formal and informal language in Polish. First, let's define what does it mean, formal and informal. The formal language will be used in formal, official situations. For example, when we have a public speech somewhere, that's the moment we use the formal language. Or in general, when we talk to strangers, the safest way would be to use the formal language, or when we write something formal, like an essay in school, or when we write a message to some public institutions. That's the time to use the formal language. And very often we can also define a semi-formal language. So not very formal, but to a large extent, yes. This would be, for example, when we talk to teachers or neighbors. Well, we know each other, but still there is a distance. We need to keep the formality to some level. Or sometimes in some workplaces, you will use a semi-formal language. You are kind of official, but well, you're not fully official. It depends on the workplace and often on the age of people you talk to. And then there is the informal language, which will be used in casual situations when, for example, talking to family, friends, and this will be mainly spoken. But also it can happen in a written form when you chat with friends or family. And sometimes you can even define a very informal language. This will be not used by everyone. And this one is used in a specific environment. Usually when we are talking to close friends or family, but not always. This will include slang or very, very informal language. And now let's see some examples where I can show you the formal and informal language in practice. First thing, what you will quickly notice is the difference between the you in Polish. We have the formal, the polite forms, pan, pani, and the informal forms, ty, for example. So when we want to ask someone, where are you? Then depending on the formality, it can be different. So, where are you, sir? Very formal. It would be, gdzie pan jest? Gdzie pan jest? Where are you, sir? Or when talking to people, like a mixed group, or a married couple, gdzie państwo są? Gdzie państwo są? Where are you, sir and madam? Or ladies and gentlemen, this could also mean. Yeah, these are examples where the formality is quite high and we use those polite forms, pan here or państwo, but there are also other forms. And an example of the same question in an informal way would be, where are you? Gdzie jesteś? Gdzie jesteś? Where are you? Or gdzie ty jesteś? Where are you? When we emphasize that. Or to many people, this would be gdzie jesteście? Gdzie jesteście? Gdzie jesteście? Where are you? This will be in plural, right? We can see here first that in the formal way we use those polite forms, pan, pani, państwo, panowie, panie. And in the informal, we will use pronouns, personal pronouns, but often we will get rid of them. We omit them and only the verb will stay. And also, if you look at the verbs have different forms. In the formal way, we have gdzie pan jest, gdzie państwo są, whereas in the informal way, we use the second person of the verbs, gdzie jesteś, gdzie jesteście, yeah? So this also differs. And we have to be careful who we talk to. You cannot ask someone, for example, a sales assistant, you don't know, using the informal way. You need to be aware that this is really important not to mix it up. Sometimes you can also find a mixture of these, especially in the plural. When we use the polite form, but the verb is in the second person. For example, gdzie państwo jesteście? Where are you, ladies and gentlemen, sir and madam? We have a mixture, państwo and jesteście. We didn't say gdzie państwo są or gdzie wy jesteście, but it's a mixture. This is like a semi-formal. This could happen, for example, when the professor at the university asks the students. Very often in this environment, you might notice mixtures. A little bit of the formality, a little bit of informality in one sentence. That's an example. Let's move on and see more examples when you see the difference in the formal and informal language. You will notice that, for example, in relation to your name, first and last name. Obviously, when we have formal situations, we will have a tendency to focus on the last names or first and last names. So introducing a person or naming the person, we will say first and last name, Piotr Kowalski, like my name is Piotr Kowalski, nazywam się Piotr Kowalski, or this is Mr. Kowalski, to jest Pan Kowalski. Here we have the title plus the surname. Yeah, that's important, the last names. But in informal situations, of course, we tend to focus on the first names. And very often, there are different versions, variants of the first names that people use. For example, Piotr, that's the first name, Peter. And then you can find some equivalents, some versions, diminutive forms, like Piotrek. It's like Peter, but in a casual way. Or Piotruś, that's how you name Peter in a very soft way, usually towards children. Piotruś will be a small Peter. And it depends what the person wants to underline, soften or sound differently, might use a different variant. What you can also notice in a semi-formal situation is a mixture. Again, you use pan, pani, the title, the polite form, and the first name, which is not very common in other languages, like Mr. Piotr, Mr. Peter would be Pan Piotr, Pan Piotr. This could happen in a semi-formal situation, for example, in some workplaces where the relationship is not so close, or maybe towards your customer, but we don't have a very intimate relationship. We still have a distance. We might use this combination. Title, polite form, plus the first name. And what could happen in the very informal situation that also happens in other languages is that we have different nicknames. Nicknames can be created based on different things, like how people look, or a modified version of their surname, or based on any situation that happened and is linked to the person. Here I gave some examples like hude, which means thin. That could be a nickname. Or Kowal, which could be a modified version of the surname Kowalski, for example. Let's see more examples. Let's see some phrases. Formally, for example, a phrase to say hello, good day, good morning would be dzień dobry, or to say good evening will be dobry wieczór. Some examples of phrases in the formal language, whereas informally you will say cześć, or also sometimes with this no cześć, well, hello, as an example. Or maybe more informally would be hey. Right, so you could see that these phrases are used in different situations. And it's not okay to mix it up. You cannot say when entering, for example, a store and talk to a stranger, you cannot say cześć, hey. That would be very impolite. But then it would be strange if you say to your friends, like teenagers, dzień dobry. That would be also weird. So knowing what kind of register, language register to use in which situation is very important. And also to mention a very informal way of saying hello would be, for example, siema. Siema, like howdy, what's up, hey, which is not maybe used in every environment and by everyone. But yes, this is maybe just to show you how those phrases would be categorized. Or formally to say goodbye, you will say do widzenia, do widzenia. And informally, this would be na razie or pa. And very informally, it would be nara. And nara is actually a shortened version of na razie. Na razie became nara. Let's see also some examples of requests in formal and informal language. For example, when we want to ask for something, like for somebody to be quiet, you can say very politely, proszę o ciszę. Proszę o ciszę. I ask for silence. Literally meaning, please be silent. But then informally, this would be maybe more like cicho, cicho, quiet. Or ch, ch, sh. So also some kind of sounds would be used in the informal language. And then if you want to say or ask someone to be quiet in a very informal way, well, it depends how much expressive you want to be. You can be more or less polite, aggressive, and then the phrase will be different. Here are some examples of in a quite offensive way. Zamknij się. Zamknij się. Shut up. Something like that. So, not maybe very polite, and even more offensive would be, as an example, zamknij mordę, zamknij mordę, shut your mouth. But again, this is just an example. Believe me, there are even more offensive ways of asking someone to be quiet. A lot of swear words would come here, and so on. Another example of a request, first formally, would be proszę wyjść, please leave, proszę wyjść. Or niech pan wyjdzie, please leave, sir. Yeah, different ways of asking for something, of a command. But informally, it would be wyjdź, wyjdź, leave. Or very informally, offensive would be wynocha or von. Yeah, like go away, go out. Very offensive. That's also important to be able to recognize what is the correctness of each phrase. when is the line of being polite, being casual, and when being offensive and aggressive. All this can be included in the words we use and phrases. The language is very powerful on what we want to say and how people react. You can also spot the difference between the formal and informal language when we describe things or situations. For example, when we describe a situation using the formal language, we will be very objective. We will focus on facts, no emotions. Well, something just happened. We just describe that. For example, samochód uległ awarii. The car has broken down. But then informally, you will tend also to express yourself more and include yourself, that you experience that in the statement. For example, kurczę, samochód mi się zepsuł. Kurczę means, it's a very mild swear word when we want to express that something happened in a negative way. Literally, it means a chicken. It refers to a very known swear word. And then samochód mi się zepsuł, you include yourself here. Samochód mi się zepsuł. The car broke down, like to me. But in a very informal way, we tend to put more stronger swear words in describing the situations as we want to express ourselves more and use words that are considered as slang or very, very informal. For example, cholera jasna. Fura mi padła. Co za złom. Yeah, we have here some expressions and words that are used only in a very informal situation and should be avoided when having formal situations. Let's see more examples of different things that are different in the formal and informal language, like some words. Matka is formally mother, a very official name, and mama would be a word already used in semi-formal situations. So this is a word that is okay to use also to strangers in a maybe less formal situation. But then informally, there are even more words that name your mom, like mommy. In Polish, it would be mamusia, mamusia. This maybe is used by children. And then informally, it could have sometimes a little bit of negative shade, or teenagers can name their mom like that. For example, stara, moja stara, which literally means my old, when talking about their mom, right? Different shades of the word. Or a man, formally, is mężczyzna. Mężczyzna. But informally, you can find a word like facet. Facet, which means a guy. And then informally, there are plenty of names how you can name a man. For example, kolo, ziom. Yeah, like a dude, something like that. More examples like face, officially will be twarz. Twarz, whereas informally you can find the word buzia, buzia. Well, buzia can mean face, but also mouth. So depending on the context, it has a different meaning. But then informally, in a more offensive way, you can name the face like morda, gęba, ryj. Not very nice words to use when describing your or someone's face. Or a cigarette formally will be papieros, and informally you can use diminutive forms like papierosek, a little cigarette. Literally this means papierosek, for example, will be used. Chodźmy na papieroska, let's go for a cigarette. This sounds like this would be something innocent. sometimes people use these diminutive forms a lot in the spoken language, in the informal language. And then very informally, like in slang, there are plenty of words that describe a cigarette. For example, schlug, it means a cigarette in slang. Palić szlugi, to smoke cigarettes. Yeah, different names for a cigarette. Money, formally, would be pieniądze. Pieniądze, but then informally, you often say kasa. Kasa, mam kasę, I have cash. Something like that. And very informally, there are plenty of names how you can name the money. For example, kasiora, hajs, forsa, szmal. This is used in slang, different variants. Also to mention about the filler words. Filler words, in English, there are many also in Polish, and this is something that occurs in the spoken language, in the informal language. Sounds like that would be very common, or words like no, which means yeah, well, no wiesz, well, you know, no tak, and so on. Or any kind of fixed phrases. Maybe somebody has their favorite and uses a lot. Just an example. Co nie? Co nie? Means right? Right? Or prawda? Prawda? Many people might have their favorite filler word and they put when speaking a lot. Also about the pronunciation, I can mention that there are differences. So for example, when we want to really be clear and speak Polish with the correct, perfect pronunciation, we will be very clear and, for example, say poszedł, poszedł, du. You will say the du at the end, meaning he went. Whereas informally, we often simplify the pronunciation and not be so super clear, especially when there are consonants next to each other. We tend to either get rid of one or combine that. For example, poszedł could be said instead of poszedł. Poszedł is much easier. Or when it comes to the word stress, there is a rule that some words have the word stressed on the third syllable from the end or on the fourth syllable, like grammatica, grammatica. Yes, this is the correct way of pronouncing. Whereas in the informal conversation, casual talks, it is totally okay when we stress the second from the end syllable, like grammatica, grammatica, right? Grammatica, super correct, grammatica, okay, casual conversation, totally fine. You can also notice that how we treat grammar in the formal language and in the casual talks will be different. For example, the super correct way would be to use ten in the accusative case for ta. Mam tę książkę. Whereas informally, when having a casual talk, it's totally fine to say mam tą książkę. Mam tą książkę, which tends to be even a form that is pushed through. So maybe someday this will be considered as also correct in the written formal language. Good. I hope that this was an interesting video for you to have a look on the different versions, different shades of the Polish language.